So, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So, I saw this video on TikTok and I was like, I have to share it here on YouTube. It's so emotional. And this comes with a feeling that only a selected few by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have. If you're born a Muslim, just forget about it. I don't think you can have such feelings. Subhanallah, subhanallah. You know, this is something you can't even imagine. Sometimes even these reverts would want to explain the feeling they have. They know this is genuine, but they can't. They can't explain the feeling. And I hope, you know, the non-Muslims watching this, I seriously hope that you would have these feelings someday. It is something that we born Muslims can't have. Okay, yes, we are pleased with Islam as our deen, as our way of life, but this is a feeling Allah has kept reserved for a few people. And I pray and I hope you're part of those people. What we ask of you is to read the Quran with an open heart, and you will be guided, inshallah. Do not take the Quran because you're looking for something to argue with the Muslims with. You're looking for something you can use against the Muslims. So let me share a verse with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and this would, you know, further strengthen the fact that we do ask people to read with an open heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَهْدِيَهُ Whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills to guide or wants to guide, يَشْرَحْ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ Subhanallah. Allah opens his chest to Islam. Allah opens his heart to Islam. That he begins to see things differently. That's why it's important that when you read the Quran, put it at the back of your heart that you're looking for the truth, and pray that your creator should guide you to that which is the truth, and you will be guided, inshallah. And despite, you know, all this, do not forget what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, la ikraha fi din. There's no compulsion in the deen, and there's a reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this. And this is why we keep pushing people to go to the Quran, read the Quran, read about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further said in that same ayah, in that same verse, Allah said, قَدْ تَبَيَّنَ الرُّشْدُ مِنَ الْغَيِّ Subhanallah. The clear path, the clear course, the right course had been made distinct from that which is false. So what is right is made quite distinct from that which is false. It is very obvious. So except you choose to turn away, or you choose to open your heart, and then you will be guided to that which is the truth. The Prophet ﷺ was reported to have said that this matter, this Islam, would reach everywhere that the day and the night is able to reach. There's no place on earth that the day or night is unable to reach. So Islam would reach every nook and cranny of the earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not leave any household in the city or in the desert except that Islam enters into it. So it doesn't really matter what you think or what your feelings are. Allah really doesn't care about your feelings. When it comes to guiding people to Islam, He doesn't really care about your feelings. Whether you like it or you don't like it, Allah would surely guide those He has destined will be guided, and will surely test from that feeling of taking the shahada. It's a feeling on a totally different level. So with this, I say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.